Okay, we're gonna do a little update on the no-till garden. So this has been planted about 6 weeks. So if you notice, there's not hardly any weeds, grass. I mean, it looks amazing. So one rule of thumb I like to do is come spend at least 15 minutes a day in your garden. That's a good time to check and see if you've got any tomato worms or, I mean, weeds, a little bit of weed, anything like that that you need to take care of. So right here on the jalapenos, these have a little something eating them. So you just kind of look around, and I don't see any bugs. So it could be one of four different things. So what we're going to do is put some dish soap spray on them, and that should move away anything that's bothering us. Now, normally this garden is, by this time, is full of grass. This grass right here grows thick, tufty, spreads everywhere. It's hard to pull out. It's just kind of a pain. But look, we don't have that this year. So I'm quite impressed with that. Another thing I want to talk about is sun. So right here is purple hull peas. These get about an hour to an hour and a half less sun than the other end. And you see how small they are, and then they get a little bit bigger. And then if you follow me down here, you'll see some that are in that extra sun, and it makes a huge difference. See this pea right here? Well, this is two of them. Look how huge they are. And they were planted on the same day, but they get, like I said, an hour and a half more sun, and it's like 2 to 3 times bigger. These are my bell peppers, same thing. Something's chewing on them. I don't see evidence. I'm kind of thinking it's probably a cutworm because of the way that it's chewed up. So I'm gonna spray my dish soap around there. Then right here we have our cucumbers, which we're gonna put on the trellis today. They should have already been done, but we just haven't got to them. Now, if you remember in the other gardening video, we used straw because it doesn't make as many weeds as the hay, but it does make these little wheat plants, but they're so simple. Look, they just pull out and they're not invasive. So in my 15 minutes a day, I just come and pluck those out and no problem. So here's our squash plants and zucchini. And we've always had a problem with squash bugs and vine borers. And the vine borers early in the season will lay their larva down in the stem next to the ground. He's tiny. We put paper cups on him, and for some reason the larva won't go in there, and so far we've had no problem at all. Now it's like the 1st of June, and that's when you really want to start looking for squash bug eggs. So you just kind of look under your leaves, check them every day, and you'll see like a little cluster of eggs. And if you see them, just take your fingernail or a butter knife or a credit card and scratch them off. Once they hatch, you can kill them with garlic oil or dish soap spray. But once they're hard bugs that look like stink bugs, they're pretty hard to get rid of. So I'm keeping a close eye on them, but I don't see any evidence so far of any. And we've always had a huge problem with them. So I don't see hardly any pests. I think part of it, let me walk over here, is because there's no, I mean, we have the straw and we have the leaves, but there's no like weeds and undergrowth for things to latch onto. I think somewhere down in here, look, we've got some little baby squashes. See? Look how healthy they are. One trick you can do is take the squash blossoms and put cream cheese in there and kind of close them up and fry them. That's pretty good stuff. Uh-oh. What is that I see down there? It doesn't look very good. This may be evidence of a borer that's put in right here. I'm gonna smother it with some dirt since I've caught it early enough, and hopefully that will smother the larva in. Kill it out. I didn't like that, but that's the only one that shows any trouble. Right here's a better example around this little chive. This is the grass that usually is covering my garden. I mean, you see how thick it is, how tough it is. When you try to pull it, it doesn't come up, it just breaks off, which means it just grows right back. And usually my garden is covered in this. It's never ending work. So I'm pretty impressed with the no-till this year. Okay, so this is my dish soap spray. This is a half a gallon sprayer. I put probably 2 tablespoons of Dawn dish liquid and just a drop of mineral oil to kind of help it hold on. I like it and shake it up. I like it to be the color of a soft Caribbean ocean water. Ooh, that's where I need to be. Anyway, we're gonna spray these. We've got this pumped up. Whoop, let's turn it. Yeah, we're gonna mist these really well on the tops. And people don't think about this, but you definitely have to do the bottoms because a lot of little critters like to hang out underneath. And then we're gonna spray all around it. So if there's any varmints or critters in there, it'll just run them off. This, I wouldn't say that this so much kills them as it deters them. They don't like it. I don't know if they don't like the taste. I don't know if they don't like the smell. I just know they don't like them, so we get rid of them. So we're gonna do all our pepper plants like this, and hopefully whatever's chewing on them quits. And I don't panic a lot about the leaves because I don't eat the leaves, but sometimes they'll pretty much just eat up your plant, and I really worry about my fruits. I don't want my fruits eaten. Okay, right here is a little bit of weed. It's spur weed, known as stickers. So this is straight vinegar, just regular old great value vinegar. And a drop of oil, same thing, it kind of helps it to stick to the plant. So this is what I use pretty much for weed killers. You spray it good, but you want to confine your spray. You don't want to use, like, let it mist everywhere because it's non-selective, which means it'll pretty much kill anything it comes into contact with. Kind of like organic Roundup. So we're gonna spray them and any other little weeds, the little wheat plants, I don't mind because they're so easy. This right here is cantaloupe. It's a little bit smaller, but I ate a cantaloupe. I kind of pulled the seeds away from the pulp and let them dry out on a paper plate for a couple of days. I came out here and I poked them in the ground and now I've got a little cantaloupe plant. So how about that for a freebie? Anyway, I'm really impressed with our no-till garden, and if you tried the technique, be sure and comment below and let us know how yours is turning out. And I guess that's it for the day. Thanks for joining us and supporting Mama's Weeds. Bye-bye.